Daredevil number 23, Chip Zdarsky, Marco Checchetto, who I hope draws this book forever. But man, seeing him draw Spider-Man in this one, he's poised for, you know, the big jump from Daredevil to Spidey, in my opinion, too. But Matt Murdock gets pissed off at Foggy for bringing in Kirsten McDuffie because of the heartbreak it brings back up to him after the breakup and having to have wiped her memory because of his identity back during the Purple Children during the Charles Soule run. So he leaves in a fit and then is met by Elektra, who says that she has some info that he might want to get onto before he goes to jail, because Matt feels like he's probably going to go to jail. Wilson Fisk is meeting with the other crime families inside their sealed bank vault. That's their, like, secret meeting place. He's going to name Izzy Libris as the new kingpin of crime because, you know, he can't be kingpin and be mayor at the same time. But due to the gang war taking place, it's like, okay, clearly you guys can't hatch this out of yourselves. I have to come back in here and fix it for you again. And as they're having this meeting, the bank vault door gets ripped off and boom, it's Daredevil. He comes in and he's like, I'm just letting you know right now, I don't care how many kingpins are on in this room. You put one in, I'm going to take one down again. And also he like kind of peers behind him and shows that Spider-Man's like sitting there menacingly too. So that was a pretty cool moment of them teaming up again after we've seen how their relationship's kind of been strained during the events of this run. But afterwards, Matt and Pete make peace with each other hanging out on a rooftop. And they embrace and have a hug as Pete mentions that the time he accidentally killed someone in Spider-Man Wolverine, and his anger and guilt kind of spewed out onto Matt there. So they, you know, they reconcile. And I only wish that they could have, you know, revealed their identities to each other there again, because they don't remember who they are anymore, which is also kind of a big frustrating thing. Because what I always liked about their friendship too was not only were like fun guys to team up with, but they also knew each other's secret identities. So not having that there is just like, it could have been one more thing that would have been nice, but it was a really good moment nonetheless. Kirsten meets with Foggy and takes away, be like, hey, why isn't Matt working on this case? As he would be super great for it too. So the next morning, when Dee Dee comes to meet Foggy and Kirsten in the office, he sees Mike Murdock sitting there as posing as Matt. So that totally connects to the annual we got a few weeks ago. So Foggy must have called him in to, you know, save face for this upcoming trial with Daredevil. Really good stuff here. Arguably, like I say it always, best book Marvel's putting out. And this is another really, really strong issue. After I feel like the Iron Man, you know, guest appearance in last issue was good, but wasn't fully great. This one was really good across the board and right back off to Zdarsky carving his name up there on that upper echelon of Daredevil writers. And along right there with Marco Checchetto being just like, once again, I hope he never leaves this book because his art is being fantastic on it.